died of a stroke. Results day for students in Scotland, but the exams body says the higher maths exam was too hard, and they say they've changed the grading system so people get the right mark. Dairy farmers in parts of the UK have been holding protests about the price they're paid for milk. Some have been buying in bulk in the supermarkets and giving it away. And another gold for Britain at the swimming. 19-year-old James Guy won the 200 freestyle. It's his second medal. He got silver in the 400 on Sunday. More from us later. Brand new Life Begins Now is next on 3.
Every bride wants their wedding to be unforgettable. Don't they?
It's about my day, about the groom.
Stoke.
Groom for a rave wedding.
And it'll all be last minute and just rubbish.
If it was my wedding, I'd be worried.
I'm quite claustrophobic.
An unforgettable new series.
Well, you can write it. I'm not doing it.
Don't Tell the Bride starts tomorrow at 9 on BBC Three. As part of our Defying the Label season, Life and Love on Disability Campus continues with The Unbreakables on Thursday night at 9. But right now on 3, it's the last few weeks at Derwent College for 6 students about to embark on a new chapter. With very strong language, Life Begins Now.
It's important for all young people to have a career plan.
Would I be a gangster, Alison?
21-year-old John dreams of the trappings of a gangster lifestyle.
Pool table, sugar, darts, obdarb, strippers.
For 3 years, he's been the leader of his own gang with two faithful right-hand men, Alid and Alid.
Best buddies.
But in 4 weeks' time, all this will come to an end when these three graduate. It's a challenging time for anyone, but particularly for someone with learning difficulties.
I got bad today because I'm leaving for good.
Emotions will run high as these three prepare to go their separate ways.
Good luck, my friends. I'm the leader of a gangsters group.
Yeah. No gangsters.
Are they part of your gang?
Yeah, those two in my gang. Okay, this name in my gang is a Bixie Lot.
Is what?
Bixie Lot. This name is Bixie Lot. It's my gang. And Jenkins in my gang, his name is Snoop Dogg. Yeah, Bothered.
Snoop Dogg?
Yeah, Bothered. Snoop Dogg is rapper. In butt off my can.
Pixie Lot. I took the troll!
Yeah.
Now!
The glass.
John Austin, Alid Thomas, and Alid Jenkins are best friends.
Austin.
They all have Down syndrome. But apart from that, they're just like any other lads.
The rest which type of girls?
Type is brown.
Me, brown. Higgins?
Hmm?
Type for girls?
Black.
Done. Black, brown, blonde.
My girls.
Me, red.
Japanese girl.
That's fine. Japanese.
For the last 3 years, they've become inseparable. But when college ends, John will have to move back home near to London and be many miles away from his two best friends, who come from Wales.
Practice for your wedding.
Oh, yes.
Where's your bride?
Where's your bride?
Him. Face to face. Get the rings.
Not a girl.
Yeah. Jigs, you are the man.
Yeah.
And him is a girl. He done it. So Jigs, tell me on him. Jigs, I do this. This kiss. I kiss boy.
How do you feel about leaving your friends?
Happy.
Really?
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 Yep. That's what I'll be. I want them gone.
Do you believe him?
Half and a half.
Half and half too. These boys are going with these switches.
Do you want to have a go with it?
Yeah.
We've been invited in by Derwent College in Shropshire to film the three lads and some of their friends in the final month before they graduate.
Get married. Come on, get married.
No, we're not getting married.
Derwent is a residential college for people aged between 16 and 25 with learning disabilities. The places are paid for by the local authorities, and it's often a real struggle to get funding, but the payoff could be huge. The ambition is for every student to learn how to live an independent life and get the skills for a job once they graduate.
Good afternoon, Jack.
So across the campus, there is a garden centre, an allotment and two cafes. These are real businesses and are partly staffed by the students.
It's not sticking. What's wrong with this jam?
John works either in the office or in screen printing.
Another good one. Well done.
All the products the college makes get sold in these bags.
My best restaurant, The Rock.
Hey.
Would you like to be a restaurant?
Yeah.
What would you call yourself?
The Rock.
You'd call yourself The Rock. Should we call yourself the printer just for this session?
Nah, call me the Rock.
Call you the Rock.
Wow.
John may hope his future will be spent in hot tubs with strippers, but the truth is when he leaves college, he'll have to say goodbye to his friends and try to get a job.
So, what we're going to do today is we're going to go through this, have a quick look at all the nice things people have said about you, hopefully. Yes. And then we're going to have a chat about when you leave college.
Yes. Good.
What's good? You're leaving college? You'll miss us, though, won't you?
Half and half.
Sharon, his tutor, is reviewing his progress over the year.
Johnny has contributed immensely to the production of screen-printed college bags and the fashion show invitations. So that means you've played a huge part in all that production down in the print area.
Oh.
So they're obviously very proud of what you've done. Johnny still needs some guidance with appropriate work behaviour. What? Now and then, you're letting it slip still, aren't you, a little bit? Yeah? Okay. So, in a nutshell, Johnny,
yeah.
It's all really good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, thank you, Johnny.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Johnny's very fun. He likes to be happy. He likes to be around his friends and having a bit of a giggle. He is definitely the lovable rogue. He's the soft side. But he likes, wouldn't like you to think he's got a soft side. He's the hard man.
What is the gangster lifestyle all about?
Gangs, smoking, drugs, and fighting.
It's not a very healthy lifestyle, is
not,
it?
Not other gangsters. Some gangsters are fit, they've got six pack. Some gangsters fat or slim or junky or smooth.
Which type are you?
Me, smooth at six pack.
So you work out a lot?
Yeah, I work out in the gym thousands of times.
John's gang is part of a much wider group of friends who are all leaving in a few weeks' time.
Hey, John.
Hey.
Number 405. I've got John.
It includes Dan and Lissy, a couple who have been together since they started here 3 years ago.
Oh, no.
Is
your sister.
Salty these chips.
No, my precious.
What?
John is kind of okay, but sometimes he gets a bit too much.
Like John and his gang, Lissy was born with her learning disabilities.
I had fits when I was a baby and I wasn't like normal kid. I wasn't like all the other kids, like all the children, because I had learning difficulty, basically. And I had some problems with my brain and that, and which I still got, you know that.
Yeah.
Which isn't that good, is it?
As my parents say at home, you can't beat a nice meal with, at the end of it, some cheese and biscuits.
Yes, you are, cheese gourmet.
Lissy's boyfriend Dan wasn't born with his disability. Something happened to him when he was very young.
So when I was a baby, I had meningitis, which actually damaged my brain, and it actually affected my brain, and then it just started to happen. Then I was diagnosed with epilepsy. And then I used to have fits, but now I've grown out of them now.
Do you ever wish you were like everybody else?
I wish we were, but you can't really change that, can you?
No, not at all, really.
You have to just be put with what you were born with, really. It is kind of really upsetting, but you have to just have to be put up the way you were born and brought up.
You just have to put up with it by the end of the day, don't you?
Yeah.
I see that possibly. You've got ants in your pants.
Both Dan and Lissy are aware of what makes them different, while in the case of other students like John, it's less clear what they understand.
Everyone who's come to the college here, or everyone here, has come because there's something that they find difficult.
They're difficult at focus, at minimise it.
What is it that you? What is it that? What is your difficulty?
My difficulty working different place. Wanting to go to shop at 8 because I want to see my girlfriend. Yeah, I can't.
Let's go!
What's that?
All my life. Their
learning disabilities mean they're less likely to anticipate what life will be like beyond college, and so being separated might come as a nasty shock.
Tonight, I'm going to be discussing a series of problems sent in by members of the public, and to help me solve the problems, I've called in a panel of experts.
This session is designed to help them deal with being apart.
Bob, Steve and Chris have been mates at college for almost 3 years. They're all leaving college soon and they're worried about how they will stay in touch and see each other after they leave.
They could go for a pint.
They could go for a pint.
They could go to the pub.
In the pub.
They could arrange. You do a little bit.
Yeah.
How would you arrange that though?
Ask them for their phone numbers.
Discuss what time to
meet up. Certain time. So, Alad, you might say to Alad, ooh, do you fancy a pint?
If you can communicate, you can arrange. Right, we'll meet up July the 12th. The dog and duck. I'm going to drink blackcurrant and lemonade.
Oh, well, that is pathetic! Guinness!
Guinness?
Guinness, is that what you'd drink if you went in for a pint?
Yeah, he liked Guinness.
Vodka.
Vodka.
Vodka and Coke.
Vodka and Coke. Well, I'm going to have a drink of water.
That is from Africa, thank you very much.
From Africa, when they drink water in Africa.
All right, I'll try. How about then, party animals drink milkshake?
No!
That's
counting that!
Milkshakes. Yeah.
The staff see a familiar pattern every year. With just a few weeks of term left, the students often start to get anxious about leaving.
Many of them don't really grasp the sort of importance of this last bit of time. They know that something significant is coming up. They know a big change is coming in their lives. For the last 3 years, they've had structure and they've had routine, if you like, for want of a better word. But this is going to change. This a new phase of their life is about to begin, and for many, it is incredibly stressful.
Outside of classes, there's little difference between Derwin and any other college. The students have busy social lives, drinking, partying, falling in and out of love.
He's my boyfriend, actually, and his girlfriend.
Guess what I wanted to? I want to marry Joe Baxter.
You're going to get married, are you?
Yeah.
Wow. When are you going to get married?
In July.
In July? What day?
24th.
24th? What day is 24th?
John is the only one in his gang to have a girlfriend.
My girlfriend,
Rachel.
What's
your name?
Emily.
How long have you been in
Ireland? About 4 weeks.
Just 4 weeks?
Yeah.
You like him, really? Have you been on a date?
She and me have a date on another day.
Oh, right. What do you like about him?
He's so sweet. Is he?
She says you're sweet.
Ah, she's gorgeous.
Tonight it's Kelly's bar. One evening a week, a cafe on the campus gets turned into a swish restaurant with waiter service. It's one of the rare occasions the students are allowed to drink alcohol.
That's what this is happening, lemonade, and I'm having a strong boy.
The posh and Becks of the college, Dan and Lissy, have come in tonight.
Please, may I have a strong boy?
Okay, yes, you can.
Thank you.
Strong boy and a lemonade.
Did you notice that he had to ask for permission for the strong boy?
Yeah, I did know that. He asked the boss's permission.
We started off being friends and then we started working up our relationship and then he asked me out and I said yeah.
And I bought an engagement ring. And then we went down to Kelly's bar.
And he proposed to me.
Of course.
You proposed in Kelly's bar, did you?
Yes.
Did you go down on one knee?
Yes, I did. And then I felt nervous when I was looking at her face and I was like, oh my gosh, what is she going to say?
Just like John and his gang, these two face living hundreds of miles apart when they graduate and move home in a few weeks' time.
Yes, Lissy, you can still make up.
The college has very strict rules for couples. They're not allowed to be alone in each other's houses. So Lissy lives with a group of girls. And Dan lives with two other lads.
What do you do here if you want to be alone?
Sometimes we go for a walk and sort things out together. And then we like to sort it out between us two. And then we help each other's feelings, don't we? And see what you feel inside.
Hey, guy in Guns N' Roses.
3 weeks ago, before term ends, and anxieties are just beginning to show. People are starting to rub each other up the wrong way.
How are you doing?
Alive, as usual. Any more questions you want to know? Like, who killed JFK? I know he did it. His father did it.
Make me.
That's impossible.
That's impossible. Yeah.
Oh, be quiet, Bruce Willis.
Yeah, that's not my name.
Why'd you call him Bruce Willis?
Because Bruce Willis has got a bald spot.
What is bald or not?
Well, Bruce Willis is bald now.
And you guys get on?
Very, very annoying.
Yeah,
nice one,
Kyle.
Okay.
Smile!
How are you? Are you well?
Oh, yeah. Oh yes, I'm very, very well on this fine particular day.
Hello. I'm Batman.
Being called Bruce Willis has really upset John.
Have you been feeling angry?
Yeah. A lot of times.
What makes you angry?
First student.
Other students?
Yeah.
Doing what?
Just warm me up. Tired.
Because he's upset, he bunks off from screen printing, and his tutor Sharon has to have a word with him.
Oh, I hate that lesson.
You don't like that lesson? I don't think you hate it. You used to love it. I've seen you in screen printing. You haven't got long left, Johnny. You need to make the most of it. She's teaching you a skill for when you leave college.
I finished this college myself, not Becky.
Yes, but Becky's teaching you something that you might use in a job when you leave college, isn't she? Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
John's problem with screen printing today might be part of a greater anxiety to do with leaving college.
He's struggling a little bit to cope with what's going on around him, plus trying to think ahead. So things are a bit more muddled for him. You can just see that niggle of anxiety that's creeping in.
Guys, you're a guy from BBC. Please do not swear. Is that right?
Another person preparing to leave at the end of this term is Stephen. He is part of a group of students who can be unpredictable in their behaviour and need one-to-one supervision some of the time. Today, he's helping with a project to resurface the tennis court with other students, some of whom are also one-to-one.
I'm just helping safety, aren't I, Ant? Adam.
Adam, excuse me.
But something was dangerous last week and I told him to stop. Mark, can I ask you a question? Please, your life on BBC, please do not swear.
Before this programme began, Mark and Alex didn't like each other very much.
Say it again.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Stephen. So what we're doing is we're getting them to work together, and by working together, they've realised that they have a lot more in common, and they now like each other quite a lot.
Right.
And they're helping
each
other.
These two lads here?
Mark here.
And Mark
and Alex over
there.
And now they're working together to realise working as a team is a really good thing. Is that right, Mark?
Yes.
Is that right, Alex?
That's right.
Adults.
And all the other parts of the team, all the other boys, feel far more relaxed knowing that these two are getting on much better and not fighting.
Unlike John's gang and Dan and Lissy, Stephen hasn't created a close relationship with the other students. In fact, his autism sometimes makes it harder for him to get on with people.
Guys, what are you trying to do now? Why are you trying to get along? Guys, no fighting.
Don't say that.
You're really good.
Can you
say
stop it?
I'm trying to focus. It's okay. See, we're staying focused. See, what I said do not swear, because that's what Davina McCall says.
Today, Stephen's session involves a shopping trip into town. He's being escorted by support workers Matt and Karen.
Right, how much is the bus then?
180.
So, how many did I say you've got to buy the bus tickets for?
Four.
10.20.
Matt and Karen want Stephen to be as independent as he can while using the bus and walking around the shops. Because of his autism, Stephen finds it very hard to concentrate on what he's doing.
What are you learning in this session?
ALS.
Yeah, but what am I trying to teach you to be?
Really good. Sensible.
Independent. So, I know you've got a lot of people here with you today, but you're still going to sit on the bus on your own.
Yeah.
Have you? We're not going to sit with you. We're going to get off at the bus station. Steve,
okay.
Listening.
All right.
And you're not going to talk to strangers, okay?
Okay.
just trying to get him not to talk to strangers.
That's for you, because I was only asking you how it's like.
Steve, listen.
Get your trolley. Right. How many are you getting, Steve? Steve, just listen. How many tickets?
£10.20.
No, how many tickets?
3, 4. We're on the BBC. Please do not swear.
Once in town, Stephen's task is to do the weekly food shop without help from others. It'll be something he needs to do on his own once he's left college.
Where did I say we had to get off the bus?
The bus office.
I didn't, did I? Where did I say? The bus station.
Yeah, but it didn't stop there.
I know it didn't. So what should we have done?
Press the button.
We should have pressed the button. To get some, but listen, if you're going to be independent, we've got to keep working on that. You have to look out the window and press the buttons.
Oops.
All right? So we're going to concentrate, Steve, now, all right?
Here, we're going past.
Are there any cars coming, Steve?
No. Please, we're being filmed, so please do not swear at them.
We're going this way, Steve. Oh.
Sorry about that. We're filming for a document. Yeah? I've looked at the file.
Everybody at the college is here for a particular reason, aren't they?
Yeah, become independent. Basically, I say the more people that we can get, the more people can be independent like us. Because what happens if when our parents go? Like, on the news, once her mum went, she had no independence if she died.
The shopping trip ended with the bus journey back to Derwin, and it had been relatively problem-free.
Thank you. Thank you for the cooperation.
Stephen, where's the shopping?
Oh, sorry. Sorry, guys.
This guy is my housemate.
And you look like a lady.
And he dressed like a blueberry girl.
Which I don't wear a bra. Hands off my nipples. You pervert!
You pervert, lady. I'll see you later, housemate.
Shut up, John.
Shut up, Johnny English.
You leave.
There's just 2 weeks to go now before the students graduate. Like many of the third years, Dan and Lissy are applying for places at new colleges and work placements near their hometowns.
I'm doing animal care course, hopefully, and I'm hoping to do a bit of acting career.
I'm doing horticulture.
Yep.
Which is part, like, land-based studies. Which is going to be growing carrots and vegetables and stuff, and then I'm going to do animal care.
Now this is a rough draft of what your e-portfolio will look like when you get it.
Here we go.
Lissy is having a final meeting with her tutor to discuss what happens when she leaves.
This page is about where I want to live. And you've put, I would like to live in Stratford-upon-Avon.
Yeah.
I would like to live in my own house with my boyfriend.
That's with Daniel.
Yeah, with some support.
Yeah, with help now, sometimes.
Yeah, and that was sensible to say you need that help. It's good that you recognise that.
Yeah, because both of us might need a bit of help sometimes.
Everybody needs a bit of help sometimes.
Everyone needs a bit of help sometimes, although perhaps not John. He's getting distracted from his work by us filming.
Are you coming in to do some work?
Yeah, I'll speak here about my job.
And when the cameras are on him, he likes to be controversial for the sake of it.
Ow.
Properly, come on, don't be silly.
I've licked my hand.
Yes, I know, but...
One day I'll be a gangster, Alison.
Come on, George.
Will you be a gangster?
Yeah.
What do gangsters do?
Guns. Bang, bang.
What, they sort of like
shoot cops.
Do you want to shoot cops?
Yeah, that's it.
But guns are
dangerous. Guns, it's dangerous. It shoot you out of the stomach.
Yeah.
A bullet right in your stomach.
So why would you want to have guns?
Shoot Golop. Shoot policemen.
Yeah, but that would be breaking the law.
Yeah, I know. It's good.
But you would, you wouldn't really want to kill anybody, would you?
Nah.
Sometimes you have to take what John says with a pinch of salt. His gang is really just interested in hanging out and having a good time.
Pint of garlic, Richard.
Like mixing their drinks.
What does it do to the lager?
Lager is hunger. I drunk.
Whenever they can, they just hang out in the computer centre. Here, instead of doing work, they listen to music. Or look at pictures of girls.
Have a quick look at what you're doing here, yeah? And think about what people might think of this stuff behind you. Alright. Needs to be appropriate, doesn't it, in work and in leisure time. Is that okay? Thanks, Ellie.
The college staff have a difficult job policing the students and making them aware of right and wrong.
Does he know that you're meeting in here?
There's been an incident on the campus. John and Alad Thomas are being called over by Paula, the support worker.
Come on, Alad, where were you two?
Another student has had some money taken from his room and Paula is investigating.
Take a seat. Right. Alad, did you speak to a member of staff this morning about some money missing? Gone from somebody's drawer?
No.
It wasn't you?
No.
Who'd you share with?
Neil and Sam.
Neil and Sam. Because Neil has said he's had some money took out of his drawer. Do you know anything about it?
No. Not me, no Thomas.
No. But, Alad, didn't you say to a member of staff that you'd been there and that someone had took the money out?
Karen.
That's it. And Alad, what did Karen ask you? Doesn't matter, Alad. You just need to say, don't you?
Mm.
OK, what did you ask her? What did she ask you and what did you tell her?
Asked me to stop.
Stop doing what?
Making Neil's money.
So, is that what you've been doing or somebody else?
Something else.
Right. Have you been involved in it as well?
No.
All right, then. I'll see you soon.
I'll have you a lot.
Bye.
The mystery of the missing money was never resolved, and if someone did take it, they were not punished. In a situation like this, the college tries to make the students understand right from wrong.
They get up to mischief, all three of them together. But you can't help but like them because they're all characters. And, like, if you watch them individually and you think, oh, and then you put them together, oh, they're really getting up to mischief here.
Hang in there, Bobbit. Everything's under control.
We're nearing the final week, and Dan is thinking about what life will be like with Lissy once they've left.
Did you tell your mum and dad about your plans to get married to Lissy?
Not yet. I was actually going to tell them near the time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why have you not told them yet?
Because I wasn't, like, didn't want them to find out. And I thought, oh, my gosh, if I told them, they'd be, like, mad.
Do you think they'd support you?
Yeah. Always.
When you think of married life, what picture do you get in your mind?
I think a nice image. Like a love heart image.
Do you think it will be difficult to be apart?
No. No, I don't think so. We're always apart all the time and it doesn't affect our relationship, does it?
No.
No.
What are you talking about?
Girlfriends. Oh. Not being dumped.
Need to find one.
So do you, mate. So do you, mate.
Have you been dumped too?
Yeah, I've been dumped too many times.
Oh, maybe we're all better off without women.
Yeah.
Oh my good God! Evan McDonald!
Best relay, four swimmers, two lengths, this end.
Dan has been chosen to captain a team in the end of term swimming gala. His team includes John, the two Alids, and Lissy. It's victory for Dan and his team. But afterwards, as the prize giving gets underway.
Swim Fit Award, 1 mile, Andrew Jackson.
There is a commotion in the men's changing rooms.
Grade 3 water skills, Sophie Martin.
It involves Dan.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's fine. Let's get your seat outside. Do you want me to come
with? Well, I've got to get a seat.
Dan has had an epileptic fit, the first in 3 years.
Sophie Martin. In second place by only a few points was the purple team.
Yeah.
If we get round him, he'll get warm.
And the winners were the red team. Yeah! Yeah! Dan Joyce isn't here. He was captain, but vice captain. Oh, sorry, Dan. Sorry. Stephen Pearce, Joe Baxter, Tommy Price, George.
In all the time we'd filmed John, he came across as a happy-go-lucky extrovert. But in the last few days of term, his mood changes dramatically. He becomes sullen and quiet. He's now regularly missing screen printing. And today, he says he's been kicked out of that session.
You were swearing in work today?
Yeah. I had to beg you to get me out.
I'm not surprised she'd kick you out. What are you swearing about?
He goes to speak about it to Alison, the student counsellor.
Get me outside.
Well, it's a bit of a disappointment, really, because after you came out of that session last week,
yeah,
we had a long talk, didn't we?
Yeah, very long talking.
I think we're going to have to do the same as last week.
Yeah.
Which is that you should go in the Bradbury Centre. You can do something on the computer. This is not so that you can go over there and just look at YouTube and things like that.
I know.
Yeah, because you should be in work.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm up with that.
Right. Should we go across the Bradbury Centre?
Yeah.
Okay. Work-related stuff on that computer.
Sure. Okay. I'll do my best.
Okay.
What sort of swearing are you doing?
Mother. F. Hunter. Hunter.
You called her an MF?
Yeah, MMF.
That's quite rude.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, because I'll be a gangster one day.
Excuse me, can you log off now? Take your earphones out. I've been over and talked to Becky.
Yeah.
Can you think what she might have said to me? Okay. Well, she said, not only have you not been put out of a session ever, you haven't even been there today. So you weren't over there swearing, John, and got put out because you didn't go. And she said, not only has she not put you out, you are very welcome to go into her session. And she would like to see you back there at 2:30, which is now. You'll feel better as we walk. and I'll stay with you a while to make sure you're settled. Go on. I know you haven't got long to go, but these days are just as important as the rest. For showing that you can stick at a job.
Yeah, I like that job. Brilliant, I hate that job.
See if we can get him settled in, and then, because I think John will work better if he can just concentrate on working.
So do you think you want to stay?
I'll put off.
Oh, I don't want to go!
John is not the only one feeling tense. Across the campus, anxiety amongst those about to leave is spreading. As preparations get underway for the prom...
Simon, do we need a bit more of a hang
on? Got my tables linked up together anyway.
Stephen is upset. He's had a trip cancelled because of his behaviour.
Can I have walks and wheels on Sunday? Can I still have walks and wheels on Sunday?
It's because of situations like this that Stephen needs one-to-one support some of the time.
Now, I need you to sit with me and I need you to talk to me rather than go mad. We work on a traffic light system, and Stephen is aware that if he's below that percentage, that there are consequences to some of his actions throughout the week. Tell me the decision that's been made.
I want to burn 5% under my average, and I don't like it. So.
And that means what?
I can't go out, and I don't like it.
When can't you go out?
Sunday.
Right.
I don't want to.
Okay.
I want to go my walks and wheelers. Don't want to concentrate. Fuck off! We need to be safe! Why don't you take it right last week? No, I don't want that! I don't want to go! Give me my own way! I won't calm down unless I get my own way!
People think that we're just sort of having the tantrums and we're not doing anything. But we have to let him get to the place where he's going to be able to talk to us after he's gone up like that. We're trying to equip him with the skills now that will take him out of college to be able to negotiate and compromise a little bit. And there are different ways of being able to get those needs met.
While Stephen goes to calm down, the other students are getting ready for the last big party before they leave.
Spot on. That's spot on.
The theme of the prom is Hollywood.
James Bond?
James Bond.
Yeah, sorry. Bond? A Bond.
Are you James Bond too?
Yeah. Same.
Stephen, how are you feeling now? All right?
I feel like a woman.
Who are you?
David Beckham. David Beckham. I started my hair up a bit tonight. A bit of water.
But really nice.
Don't drink too many.
I try not to.
Let's go.
Right, my man. Here we go.
It's a chance to celebrate the time they've all shared together here.
I'm so bad today because I'm leaving for good.
You'll make new friends. You will. Of course you will. You will, Johnny.
I want to stay with you, Alex.
Is that what it is? You're going to miss the Alex?
Yeah. I just want to focus.
You've lost your focus?
Yes, I lost my focus and now I lost my heart.
Oh, Johnny.
So my feelings is gone.
I think your feelings are a bit mixed up, aren't they?
Yeah.
My feelings, I live in this college. I'd be nervous. And my brain said me stay in college to do work that work. You're gone, you're leaving. Yeah, me, I'd be upset, I'm leaving. But my feelings are about.
Hi guys. Gonna miss you all.
It's graduation day. Across the campus, third year students are packing up their belongings and their parents are arriving to take them home.
I don't want to leave, but I've got to.
Yeah, huh?
I see you won a swimming thing yesterday. Swimming sports winning team 2014.
All right. Oh, how are you?
Good.
Yeah?
Good, yes.
Why haven't you spoken to us on the phone, eh, John?
My voice, really.
Oh, is it?
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to formally welcome you to our Leverage graduation ceremony for 2014. This award for Outstanding Student for 2014. That award goes to Daniel Jones.
You should come along, all of us, and say goodbye, one by one.
Right.
You missed out, Shane.
See you guys soon.
Take care, lovely.
See you soon.
Give me a cuddle.
Be good.
He's a jolly good fellow. He's a jolly good fellow. He's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us.
It's just very emotional. Probably still a little bit emotional at the moment for reasons being. So.
Is it just the one bag?
Yeah.
I'll text you when I get in.
Okay.
Love you.
I'll see you tonight, okay?
Okay. Yeah. Love you, babe.
Love you.
What shirt are you wearing?
I don't know.
They got a new spare bar with for you.
Are you leaving your first station now?
No.
No, tomorrow. We're leaving.
We're leaving for good. Hey, Lewis, I want to give a hug for you.
Yes.
Good luck, my friend. And I'm going to Cardiff. I'll see you in Cardiff.
Yeah.
And you get out, Justin!
I'll see you in Cardiff. I'll pick you up in Cardiff.
Justin.
Big
boy.
Hey, Justin. Hey, Justin.
Hey,
Justin.
Lovely.
Yeah.
It's good to see you.
Okay.
You know,
too bad.
Yeah.
All meet up together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And
see you.
Bye bye.
Captain, on my voice.
We catch up with the six students 5 weeks after they've graduated. How are they adjusting to life on the outside?
Give us a cuddle.
I love you.
Stephen is on holiday in Clacton with his family.
Basically, in here, you've always got a bit wall here. That's for fire safety, that is, that bit wall.
He did have a place to live in some supported accommodation, but it has fallen through.
How have you found it, Stephen, since leaving college?
Hard.
Hard?
Feels strange. It's not, you can't see the hills every day.
Can't see the hills.
Feels weird.
I think Stephen's feeling very uncertain about what's happening. We don't know where he's going to live yet. We don't even know which town it's going to be in. We don't know what he's going to be doing. He's just come to the end of a big sort of part of his life, being at college, where everything was organised, he was part of a big community. It's all just a really question of just fingers crossed. And hope for the best, really.
How are you finding having him back home?
Well, it's okay. You know, obviously, because I'm his mum, I love him to pieces. It does make a difference. I lose my me time that I had. Nothing is private anymore. You can't leave anything around. But I wouldn't alter it for the world.
Hey,
my son will always be my world.
Hey.
How are you?
Dan and Lissy now live 200 miles apart, and this is the first time they've seen each other since leaving college.
Hi there, Lissy.
Hello. Nice switch.
I know.
Kiss. Thank you.
Do you still feel like you might want to get married?
Yes.
Yes, but we can't tell our parents, can we?
We shouldn't. Just trying to back things in mind.
I'm just trying to keep it quiet, though, because I don't want...
She's been trying to keep her lips sealed.
Well, they do know that we're engaged, don't they?
Yes.
That's the only bit they know.
Yes.
This will be the first time they've been together under a roof that isn't college and college rules, so I think we're all finding our feet a bit with it, aren't we?
Yeah. I'm sure during the weekend they're going to end up... Yeah. In the room, but I mean, they're also going to know that people could pop in at any time, so I think that would put the brakes on it. Any exploration that might go on.
Very diplomatically thought.
Good touch. Left foot. It's dangerous.
And so, what's of John Austin and his gang?
Yep.
Down near High Wycombe, John still has ambitions to join a brotherhood, but his mum isn't very pleased with the idea.
Mum, I need a ghetto group, like a gang. Gang, but men's.
No. Having a group of friends that are known.
Yeah, group of friends.
You know, as a gang. But you need to be careful because gangs can be not very nice things as well. So it's better to talk about having a nice group of friends. But you're not gangsters, you're just a nice group of friends. Thank you. Whilst other youngsters also can show an interest in that, they have an ability to understand the negative sides of that culture as well. The likes of Jonathan doesn't have that ability to rationalise the inappropriateness of that sort of genre of either music or culture. And that's the challenge.
John hasn't seen either of his two best friends, and he's missing them a lot.
Well, I'll sleep over party.
Well, you can have a sleepover party. We'll get Neil round yours.
Oh, I won't do Alice.
Oh.
Yeah, how?
When we can get you sorted out with you flatten things, then, you know, then you can start building a sort of social life. You'll make new friends because you'll be with other people.
No new friends. Yeah. I want to sit with two Alice.
Aled Thomas is helping his father with the sheep on the family farm in Wales. He's seen Aled Jenkins a few times, and they talk most days on the phone.
Jenkins!
He's just got funding to go back to Doe and college for another year, but he's worried he'll miss his two best friends.
Are you glad that he's got another year at Doe?
Yes, I am glad, but, you know, at the end of the day, he's going to be happy there. And if he's not happy...
Oh, too true.
..he's home.
So makes a kids.
Miss Jenkins, yeah, and now Jonathan, mine, both the same, aren't they? Well, you see Jenkins.
Miss them both.
Yeah.
OK, yeah. Right. Oh, Aled. Come on. You all right?
Over then.
Yeah.
Over and down. Voila.
That's where you're going to have it.
X marks the spot.
Aled Jenkins is starting at a college not far from his family's farm. He's also about to start building his own bachelor pad bungalow.
What do you want?
Jacuzzi.
Jacuzzi.
He wants a hot tub.
I don't think he cares about anything else. So. I think it's a lovely idea, but company's a big thing, isn't it? The great thing about Derwin is that he had two mates and that he was in a crowd. And he was happy because of it. And for us to provide a social life with it for him is the most difficult thing.
Do you think he's a bit lonely?
I think there's a danger that he might be, yeah. That's the thing that frightens me most.
But Aled knows the perfect way to keep loneliness at bay.
You want to paint the house pink?
Yeah. And girls for the colour.
Way of sort of getting girls into the house.
Yeah.
Quite wily.
What are the issues for young college leavers seeking independence? Are they the same for everyone? Find out more with the Open University and have your say. Go to bbc.co.uk/lifebeginsnow and follow the links to the Open University.
For details of organisations which offer advice and support on disability, you can go online to the BBC website or call the BBC Action Line to hear recorded information on 08000 680 133. Lines are open 24 hours and calls are free from landlines and mobiles.
Dad, how much does a cloud weigh?
What do gorillas talk about?
Dad, how fast can a bee fly?
Can cows swim?
Has anyone ever found an alien?
Our freshers have settled in well at National Star, a further education college for those with disabilities. It's Spin the Bottle with the Unbreakables Thursday at 9. While you can go to the BBC Three YouTube page right now to watch our fresh films on disability, including MS and Me.
Sam, here's our check on the global news channels. Deadly floods ravaging many parts of southern Asia. On CNN, they showed a road collapsing in China. Indian network Aajtak reckoned almost 200 have been killed there. NBC said Californian wildfires are going from bad to worse. CBS spoke to locals having to flee their homes. The threat from looters was identified on GMA. Dramatic pictures on Sky of two cranes collapsing in Holland. They fell onto homes by a canal. NOS spoke to the lucky locals who escaped unhurt. ARD covered the German MP opening up his home to migrants. Martin Patsells helping two Eritreans find a job. He said it's to stop hostility to refugees. And Sausage Roll was Nine's headline in Australia. They met the Dachshund on two wheels.